Friends, welcome once again to my exam coaching classes. And first of all, thank you very much for watching my videos and supporting me. Okay, so today we are going to see part 3, that is question paper solution part 3. So here in this video I have brought beautiful questions selected from the previous question papers regarding numerical ability. Okay, so we'll be solving some of the very important questions from numerical ability parts. Directly let us go to the questions first. Okay, here is your first question. So what is your first question? The first question is, find the ratio compounded of the duplicate ratio of 5:6, the reciprocal ratio of 25:42, and the sub duplicate ratio of 36:49. So you have to find out the compounded ratio of duplicate ratio of 5:6. So we should understand what is duplicate ratio, subduplicate ratio, reciprocal ratio, all these things we have to understand it. So before going to this question, let me take 1 minute to tell you what is a duplicate ratio, what is a subduplicate ratio, and what is a reciprocal ratio. For example, suppose we have a ratio A:B. Suppose we have a ratio A:B. So A:B can be written as what? A:B can be written as A/B. A:B can be written as A/B. So now the first part is what? That is duplicate ratio. Whenever we have duplicate ratio, students understand A/B is the ratio. So duplicate ratio of A/B can be written as A/B into A/B. Means you have to duplicate it two times. Okay, A/B into A/B, that is duplicate ratio. So you understood what is duplicate ratio. So the second part it is given, it is the reciprocal. So reciprocal ratio means A/B will become B/A. So reciprocal ratio is A/B, we have to written as B/A, that is reciprocal ratio. And subduplicate, when we talk about subduplicate, A/B ratio we have to written as root A by root B. So you understood what is a duplicate ratio, you understood what is a reciprocal ratio, and you understood what is a subduplicate ratio. So understand this concept, then it is very easy to solve this type of questions. So duplicate ratio, triplicate ratio, like that it will come. So duplicate ratio means you have to duplicate it, you have to multiply it. Subduplicate means you have to reduce it to the square root. And inverse or reciprocal means you have to take the upside down. Numerator will go to denominator and denominator will go to numerator, upside down, inverse. So understand this concept, then it is very easy to solve this type of questions. So now let me remove this and let us go to the question now. So what is given in the question? You have to find out the compounded ratio of duplicate of 5/6. So first information is duplicate of 5/6. What is duplicate of 5/6? Pen is not working, so let us change the pen. Okay, 5/6 duplicate 5/6. So I'll get 5/6 into 5/6. I'll get what? 5 into 5, 25/36. So I can write it as 25:36. Then what is given in the second part? Second part is reciprocal ratio of 25 and 42. Reciprocal ratio of 25 and 42. So 25/42 is reciprocal will become 42/25. So reciprocal ratio we got. So that is what? 42:25. So that is a reciprocal. This is a duplicate. And what is the third part given in the question? Third part is subduplicate of 36 and 49. Subduplicate of 36 and 49. So subduplicate means root of 36 by root of 49. So root of 36, students, you know it is 6. Root of 49 is 7. So I can write it as 6:7. So we have written the duplicate, we have written the reciprocal, we have written the subduplicate. Now what is asked in the question? The compounded ratio of all these three. The compounded ratio means you have to multiply all these three. So when you multiply, it will become 25/36 into this will become 42/25 into this will become 6 by 7. So now I can cut this 25 and 25. I can cut 6, 36, 6 times. I can cut 6 and 42, 7 times. I can cut 7 and 7. Everything will become 1 by 1. So the correct answer is 1:1. The correct answer is 1:1. So accordingly, you have to do and find out the correct answer. So understand what is duplicate ratio, understand what is reciprocal ratio, understand what is subduplicate ratio, and compounded ratio means it is the compounded multiplication product of all these ratios. Understood? I hope you understood the concept. Please note it. So let us go to the next question. So the next question is here on your board. So what is the question? The question is 4x plus 3 is to 9x plus 10 is the triplicate ratio of 3:4. Then find the value of x. 4x plus 3, 9x plus 10. So what is given is 4x plus 3 is to 9x plus 10. This ratio is the triplicate ratio of the given ratio. So triplicate ratio of 3:4 means, triplicate ratio of 3:4 means you have to write this is equal to 3 by 4 into 3 by 4 into 3 by 4. So in the previous question we have seen what is duplicate. We have multiplied it by 2 times. Triplicate means you have to multiply it by 3 times. So this ratio will be equal to triplicate of this ratio, that is 4x plus 3 divided by 9x plus 10 will be equal to 3 by 4 into 3 by 4 into 3 by 4. So now we can write it as what? 4x plus 3 by 9x plus 10 is equal to 3 into 3 9 9 into 3 27, 4 into 4 16 16 into 4 64. So from here I have to find out what is the value of x. What is asked? You have to find out the value of x. So now when you find out the value of x, you have to cross multiply it. So 64 into 4x, so this can be written as what? 64 into 4x, so 64 will come out here. You will write 4x plus 3 is equal to this cross multiplication, 27 into 9x plus 10. So when you solve this, 64 into 4, 4 4s are 16, balance 1, 24 plus 1, 25, 25x plus 3 4s are 12, 3 4s are 12, balance 1, 18 plus 1, 19 is equal to 27 into 9, 9 7s are 63, balance 6, 18 plus 6, 24x plus 270. So 256x and 243x here. So you can cut this 256 and 243. So you will get how many x? You can cut this and this, total will be 13x. 192 here and 270 there. You can cut that 172 and 270, you got is equal to 78. So students, what I am actually doing, 256x here, I am taking this 243x this side, this will become minus. So cancel and cancel, 13x will be left. Here you have 270, here you have 192. When I take this 192 that side, it will become minus. So you can cancel and the remaining will be 78. So 13x is equal to 78. So what will be x? X will be equal to, you can cut this 13 and 78, how many times? 6 times. So I got x is equal to 6. This is only simplification. Once you practice, simplification becomes very easy. Okay, so finally you find out the value of x. X is equal to 6. So simplification part you can do, you already done it. The concept, the main concept here is you should understand what is triplicate of a ratio. Triplicate of a ratio is you have to multiply it by 3 times and then equate that with the given ratio and find the value of x. So these type of questions are very, very easy once you understand the concept. And once you practice 3-4 questions like this, then you can easily approach any questions coming from these topics, and it is not at all difficult. And the more you practice, you can increase your speed, and kindly note it now. So the next question. So the next question is here. What is the next question? The next question is, if x plus 5 is to 3x plus 4, is the duplicate ratio of 5:8. Then find the value of x, x plus 5 and 3x plus 4. So it is given x plus 5 is to 3x plus 4 is the duplicate ratio of what? Is a duplicate ratio of 5:8. It's a duplicate ratio of 5:8. Since it is a duplicate ratio given in the question, that is why I have written 5/8 × 5/8. So now what we can write is x plus 5 divided by 3x plus 4 is the duplicate ratio of 5 × 5/8 × 5/8. So this is the information given in the question. So according whatever is given in the question, accordingly we have already written the information. Now from here you have to find out what is x. So you can write it as what? 5/8 × 5/8 is 25/64. So x plus 5 by 3x plus 4 is equal to 25/64. You have to cross multiply. When you cross multiply, this will become what? 64 × x plus 5. 64x plus 64 × 5. 5 fours are 20, balance 2, 30 plus 2, 32, is equal to, this is 64x, and this cross multiplication, 25 × 3, 75x plus 25 × 4, 100. So here I got 64x, here 75x. I can cut 64x this side, that side 64x, remaining x will be 11x. Here you have 320, here you have 100. Cut 100 with the 320 and you will get 220 balance. So 11x is equal to 220. So 11 and 22 I can cut 2 times. So x is equal to 20. So your answer is x is equal to 20. This simplification part you can practice and finally you got the answer x is equal to 20. So this is the way you have to approach this type of questions. All the first three questions we have selected from ratio. Okay, so kindly note it, then we will go to new questions. Please note it. Okay, let us go to the next question. So the next question is here on your board. What is the next question? Find the average of first 10 prime numbers, the mean of first 10 prime numbers. So average of the first 10 prime numbers or mean of the first 10 prime numbers, mean, average, all these are same only. So you have to find out the mean of first 10 prime numbers. The question here is prime numbers. So you should understand what are prime numbers, what are composite numbers, what are odd numbers, what are even numbers. All this concept we have already learned in the video number system. So again, I'm requesting you students, if you have not watched the video number system, kindly watch that first and then it will be easy for you to solve this type of questions. Okay, so you have to find out the mean of first 10 prime numbers. So let us understand what are prime numbers first. What are the first 10 prime numbers? We know prime numbers are those numbers which have only two factors, then 1 and the number itself. Only two factors, numbers like 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, these numbers are called prime numbers. Okay, so prime numbers will not have any other factor other than the number and 1. So let us write the first 10 prime numbers. The first 10 prime numbers will be 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17, 19, then 23, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 23 and 29. So these are all the first 10 prime numbers. Okay, so when you add this first 10 prime numbers, you have to find out the what is the mean of these numbers. So when you add all these numbers, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10, we have total 10, and you have to add this 2 plus 3 5 5 plus 5 10 17, then 17 plus 11 28, 28 plus 13, how much? 41, then 58, 77, 77, 100, 129. So I got total 129. So 129 divided by 10, I'll get the answer 12.9. So 12.9 will be the average of all these numbers. So that is what asked in the question. You have to find out what is the mean of first 10 prime numbers. So we have written the first 10 prime numbers, then we have added it divided by total number. How many numbers are there? 10 numbers. We have divided by 10 to get the mean or average. So accordingly we have found the correct answer. Please note it. Okay, so let us go to the next question. Okay, so the next question is here on your board. What's the question? The average of 50 numbers is 38. If two numbers like 45 and 55 are discarded, then the average of the remaining numbers is what? So you have the average of first average of 50 numbers is 38. So it is given average of 50 number is 38, and the total 50 numbers you are discarding, you are subtracting numbers 45 and number 55. So remaining numbers, what will be the average? So you have, now you can say from the given question, you can say total number n is equal to 50. Total how many numbers are there? 50 numbers. So now second, what we can say from here is average, that is x bar, is equal to 38. So total sum will be how much? Total sum will be 50 into 38. Out of this total sum, you are subtracting two numbers. What are the two numbers you are subtracting? 45 and 55. So the new sum will be equal to what? New sum will be 50 into 38. From here you are subtracting 45 and 55. Then new average will be what? New average will be equal to this sum, that is 50 into 38 minus 45 and 55 will become 100 divided by, initially 50 numbers were there. Now you are subtracting 2. So how many left? Only 48 is left. So this will become what? 50 into 38. So 50 into 38 minus 100. So you can say 0, 5, 8s are 40, balance 4, 15 plus 4, 19 minus 100 by 48. So this will become 1800 divided by 48. 50 into 38 you got 1900. 1900 minus this 100 divided by two numbers you are subtracting. So out of 50, when you subtract two numbers, the remaining number will be 48. So final answer you got 1800 minus 48. So when you solve it, it will become you can cut it with the 2. Yes, 24 times, here it is 900. Again you can cut it with the 2, 12 times, this will become 450. Again you can cut it with the 2, 6 times, this will become 225. So again you can cut it with the 3, this will become 2, this will become 73. So 73 divided by 2. So your final answer will be 73 divided by 2. You can write it as 37.5. Is it correct? 18, 24 and 900. Again, you are cutting it with a 2. How much? 12 and 450. Again, 2, 6 and 225. Then you are cutting it with a 3. So save here, it become 5. Sorry, 75. So it is 75 divided by 2, 37.5. So answer is correct. 37.5 is the correct answer, and you can correct it from the options. Okay, kindly note it. Okay, so let us go to the next question. So what is your next question? The next question is, a 100 meter long train is moving at a speed of 60 kilometer per hour. In what time will it cross a signal pole? So what is the information given? So students, this is the question selected from time and distance topic. So again, I am telling you, time and distance, we have already uploaded a video in which we have already explained what is the relation between time, distance and speed, what all are the important formula we should use when we solve questions related to time, distance and speed. So the description for that, the link for that video is also given in the description. Kindly watch that, then come to these questions, then it will be very, very useful for you. Okay, So we have already practiced all this, and this is revision actually. So let us go to the question and see what is the information given. You know, we have already seen how to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, how to convert meter per second to kilometer per hour, how to convert hour into minutes and seconds. All these conversions we have already learned. So we will be applying all this concept here. So what is the question given here is, a train crosses a pole and the length of the train is given 100 meter. So let us take length of the train. When a train crosses a pole and when a train crosses a platform, or when a train crosses another train, overtake another train, all these concepts are very, very different. Okay. So in this question, it is given that a train crosses a pole. When a train crosses a pole, a point object, then the distance covered will be equal to the length of the train. When a train crosses a platform, then the distance covered will be equal to sum of the length of the platform and length of the train. So all these concepts we have already discussed, so I am not repeating it again. I am going to the questions directly. In this question, a train crosses a pole, so the distance covered will be equal to the length of the train. So what is the length of the train given here? 100 meter. So we will take distance is equal to 100 meter. So distance covered is equal to 100 meter. It is given in meter. But students, you can see the speed. Speed is given in kilometer per hour and the distance is given in meter. So obviously it is understood that we have to convert that kilometer per hour into meter per second. So what is the formula we have already learned to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second? We have to multiply kilometer per hour by a factor called 5/18. So here speed is given as what? Speed is equal to what is given? 60 kilometer per hour, equal to 60 kilometer per hour. So that is equal to 60 × 5/18 meter per second. So this will be equal to what? You can cut a 60 and 18. How many times? 2, 9 times. Here 2, 30 times. So again, you can cut here 3, 10 times. Here 3 times. 10 × 5, 50. So 50/3 meter per second. So I got speed, I got distance. So what is asked in the question? In what time will it cross the signal pole? So time is what we need to find out. So what is the distance? Distance, speed and time. Distance is equal to speed into time. We need to find out what? We need to find out time. So time is equal to distance by speed. So time is equal to distance 100 divided by speed 50/3. So this 3 will go to top, it will become 300 divided by 50, 0 cancelled. So this will become 5 and 30, 6 times. So it is in 6 seconds is the answer. So you can find out the time is how many seconds? 6 seconds. In 6 seconds, the train will definitely cross that pole. Understood? So concept is very, very clear. And again, I'm telling you, students have problem solving these type of questions from distance, time and speed topic. The link is given in the description, kindly watch and then come to these type of questions. It will be very, very easy for you. Okay, kindly note it. Okay, let us go to the next question. So the next question is here on your board. What is the next question? The next question is, Kiran covers a certain distance 80 kilometer per hour and returns back to the same point at 20 kilometer per hour, then the average speed during the whole journey will be what? So Kiran covers a distance at 80 kilometer per hour and returns to the same point at 20 kilometer hour speed. So now you have to find out what is the average speed. So you have a very, very important formula to find the average speed. We have already learned what is the speed formula for average speed. Average speed is equal to 2xy divided by x plus y. 2xy divided by x plus y is the formula to find out the average speed. So according to this question, he covers a distance at a speed of 80 kilometer per hour. So we'll get x is equal to 80 and he returns to the same point at a speed of 20 kilometer per hour. So y also we got. Put it in the formula. So here you got 2 × 80 × 20 divided by x plus y. 80 plus 20. So 2 into 80 into 20 divided by 8 plus 20. So here you got 80 into 20, 16 plus into 2, 32. 3200 divided by 100. You can cut 0, 0. You got the answer 32 kilometer per hour. So 32 kilometer per hour will be the average speed. So if it is in the correct option, if it is in the options, you can mark it.
Okay.
So average speed is calculated using the formula 2xy divided by x plus y, or you can say 2ab divided by a plus b. Different formulas we have already studied and we have practiced that formula in the previous videos. Okay, kindly note it. Okay friends, so more and more questions we have to solve in the upcoming videos. Okay, so part 1 and part 2 we have already seen different questions asked in the previous question papers, and we have a lot of questions collected from previous question papers, and we will be solving all the questions in the upcoming videos. Okay, we'll meet again with new topics and new videos. Okay, take care then. Bye bye.